detoxify your mind and body. Be the change you wanna see. Small steps towards living better. Small steps to where I wanna be.
Hey, what's up, guys? Today we're talking about emotional detox. Now, detoxification has several different aspects to it that you will experience if you are in this for the long haul. There's physical detoxification, spiritual, emotional, what have you. You know, and I think one of the most difficult aspects to it is the emotional detox. Now, as we've been growing up from childhood, we have had so many different outside influences try to develop and shape us into the shell of what society thinks we should be and who they think we should be. And you start to believe that that is who you are. So when you clean up your diet, your environment, your lifestyle, your body is going to start eliminating the physical toxins that have built up your entire life from poor diet and poor environment. Now, as this happens, there's going to, of course, be emotional detox attached to this, because when there's toxins within the body, that has a direct effect on our mental state. So if the body is clean, the mind is going to start to detoxify as well. And this is probably one of the most uncomfortable situations that are involved in detox. So, like I said, society has done quite a job on us since childhood to make us believe we are something that we most likely are not. You know, we've got teachers, we've got parents, friends, we've got the billion-dollar industry using their marketing tactics to make us think that we are a certain way and that we should act and feel a certain way so that we fit in and are nice little consumers in this society. Now, when you start to detox, it's going to be just like an onion, you know, the old onion analogy where you're peeling away the layers. You're actually going to start to peel away a lot of this programming that you have been inundated with since childhood. You know, how to act cool, how to, you know, look good for the ladies, how to do whatever it is that we are told is important in life. Now, while not all of these things are negative, there are a lot of things about them, the way that we look at them, that are negative. And that is all due to a lot of programming, a lot of outside influence, and all of that sort of thing. So, when you are peeling away those layers through detoxification, it's going to be uncomfortable. You may start to forget how to basically interact with other people, whether it's people in the new paradigm that you are trying to get into, you know, trying to set yourself up in that you feel is the right way to go, the right environment, the right lifestyle. And, or if it's the people in your old lifestyle, you know, it can be difficult either way. Because it's really not about the paradigm that you're living in. It's about finding out who you really are. And that's really going to start to show itself once you are detoxing. After all these layers are peeled away, you're really left with an infant emotional state. You know, you're really at the basic level of your personality, of your emotional state. And that's going to take time to develop and to build back up into your true self, into that true confident state where you know who you are and you know what you want and how you're going to get it. Instead of what that shell that we had been programmed in, you know, all that marketing from the movies, the cartoons that we've grown up with, the commercials, our teachers telling us, no, don't act that way, act this way, and your parents telling you the same thing. Basically just society, the way society wants us to be is what we have just been pummeled with our entire lives. So now that those layers have really started to peel back, you're able to start building on that foundational basic state, how you really truly feel, and how, you know, you really start to connect with your intuition. And that is the main guide that you are going to want to follow. You know, really listen to your intuition, listen to your inner voice on what is important to you, what you should be doing, how you should be acting, and use it to kind of find different paths that are going to lead you to self-improvement, self-development. You know, there's so many different influences, you know, both subconscious and conscious, that we take on a daily basis, that it really comes down to just being able to look inside rather than outside to really determine if that is what you want to bring on as a layer of who you are. And when you are so clean within your body, your intuition is going to really kick in, and you'll be able to follow it to what you really know deep down is truth, is beneficial to you, and is going to really help you develop yourself. So, you know, I know people really have a difficult time with this. You know, you might feel awkward in every social situation. You may lose your ability even just to have the most basic small talk. Everything could seem awkward in every social situation. And, you know, this can be very uncomfortable. It can cause people to feel depressed because they just don't feel like they can connect with anybody. And it's really about connecting with yourself first. You really have to go within yourself. You really have to just take time to understand what you are doing, who you are. And then, you know, things will start to improve. Think your personality will start to take on your, you know, its true self, rather than trying to fit in the mold of what everything else is trying to make us into.